Up next, Full Circle.
Full circle, yes, we rotate 360 degrees. Ha ha, 360 degrees. Ha ha, 306, 306, 360 degrees. Ha ha.
Welcome to Full Circle, your community radio magazine produced by apprentices of the First Voice Media Action Program. Tonight, we bring a very special guest from the Full Circle live performances with the band Space Heater. Part of the Jazz Mafia crew, Space Heater has succeeded in earning support from audiences in and around the Bay Area.
Space Heater's debut release, The Record, in 2006, received strong sales and top charts at independent college radio stations in North America and Europe. Their new self-titled album, Space Heater's Blast Furnace, is set to drop Tuesday, September 8th. So let's go straight to their first song, Lonely Staircase. Then we will meet the members of the band. We're your hosts, Sukari and Living Lamont. Keep it locked right here on Full Circle, KPFA 94.1 FM. Welcome back to Full Circle here on 94.1 KPFA. We're here live in the studio with the band Space Heater. So that was a tune called Lonely Staircase. And we'd like to welcome you all here. We're here with the band's leader, actually, Evan Francis, founding member of the group. How's it going, Evan?
It's all good, Sukari. How are you doing?
Great. Great to have you here. Thanks so much. That was a great way to start it off. So can you introduce us to the band?
Absolutely. I'll go counterclockwise.
Okay.
Over here on the electric bass, we have Tommy Follin.
Go for it.
Who is loyally referred to as El Fulano de Tal. Next to him, on the drum sets and cymbals and samplers, Patrick P. Dub Corti. on the congas and other percussion, we have Matt Lucas.
Yes. Woohoo!
All right, here we go.
A special guest today filling in for our good friend Casey Knutson, who had a family emergency, coming in at the last minute to kill it. The wonderful person who I refer to as the Archbishop of Crazy Town, Matt Nelson.
All right.
Oh, right on.
To my right, also playing tenor saxophone, is Marcus Steffens.
What is that?
So, I understand that Space Heater began as a duo. Can you describe the origins of Space Heater?
Yeah, sure. I moved to SF in 03. I followed a woman up here, and her roommate was a man named Bill. They lived at 16th and Cap. It's an exciting little intersection. So, we were hanging out there late one night and partying, and me and Bill started messing around in his computer. I had all my instruments there, my sax and my clarinet and my flute. And the next morning, we woke up and we listened to what we had made and we liked it. So we decided to pursue it. So I started to go into his house and we started making music. And before we knew it, after much, you know, wandering musically, we wound up making a record. And then we were in touch with Daddy Kev down in L.A., who is the leader of Alpha Pup Records, the founder of Alpha Pup Records. And so we put it out and we started playing gigs. That's what happened.
So the name, Space Heater, that's an appliance. But we're sitting with a six-member band right now.
It's a six-member appliance.
So, explain.
Well, it started out as Portable Heater, which I kind of like better, even though it's not as snappy. I like Portable Heater because it sounds kind of funny, it sounds kind of awkward, and that's kind of the type of stuff that I'm into. But yeah, we wound up, after arguing about it, we did a lot of arguing. He was on the Space Heater side, I was on the Portable Heater side. That's it. I mean, we were like two little people, you know, we just kind of like made little music. It was like a little appliance that you could move around and it would create heat, so to speak.
And so now we've gone from the duo to Space Heater's Blast Furnace. So tell us a little bit about that incarnation.
Yes, well, that story has to do with a strip club. Not exactly. The Condor is a famous San Francisco strip club in North Beach. My friend Pamela was booking that place for music, and she was like, hey, why don't you bring Space Heater to the Condor? We never played there while it was actually a strip club. It was a seafood restaurant. Because she called me to put a band together, I was like, well, I'm going to take these tunes that I arranged for just me and another guy who was like a producer, you know, who would basically spin records. I just like expounded on it and made it into a, you know, I wrote it on music sheets and I called my favorite musicians to come play the music. And then I heard the sound that they created when they played those compositions in that combination of people. And so it inspired me to write a bunch more music, which I have, and we play it now. Still.
So right, let's on. Do that.
Yeah, let's do that. Let's get into some more music here.
I was going to say, let's do that.
Let's hit it, Space Heater. 94.1 KPFA.
Tonight, we are bringing you a very special live performance with the band Space Heater. Their self-titled album, Space Heater's Blast Furnace, comes out on September 8th. You are listening to Full Circle here on 94.1 FM KPFA. We're your hosts, Sukari and Living Lamont. And that song that you just heard was called Krusty, George Washington. And before that, we heard Other Sunshines and Crazy Skeleton.
Can you talk about the influences and the roots of your music?
Where could I start?
I heard a lot of Afro-Cubano going on there.
Yeah.
So
yeah, it's definitely. I guess I've been pretty enamored by the music of Cuba and Puerto Rico for a while now. I listen to a lot of Pablito, F.A. Hay, and a lot of Los Bonbon. I listen to Charanga, Banera, and I love timba. I just love the music called timba too. I don't know exactly how to define it, but it's kind of more modern, like salsa from Cuba. And it makes use of a lot of different, like, effects. It's influenced by a lot of pop and, like, you know, even, like, funk and even smooth kind of music. And I really like how they make different usage of the instruments, like the bass does all kinds of funny stuff in that music. It's kind of like an organ. When you're playing an organ and certain stops, like you'll pull out a stop and it'll turn into a different instrument. Mm-hmm. A lot of times that'll happen, like the bass will drop out and then the drummer will kind of like play stuff on the tom-toms. And like, so it'll kind of like replace the bass, you know, like, so as if you're playing, to continue the analogy with the bass, it's like the piece of organ that's making the bass sounds, all of a sudden the stop gets turned into a different stop and you're hearing a different sound instead of that. You know, so it's like something drops out, another thing comes in, and the whole sonic thing gets slowly changed in that way. I also like how melody, like, hangs over the bar line, you know. Like, a lot of times melodies, they don't start and end at the same time as the drum beat. They'll, like, hang over, or they'll start a little ahead of time. And what I try to do in this music is to kind of arrange the drums, like, the percussion parts to accommodate for that. So it kind of messes with your head a little bit because you think, oh, it's still going to keep going on that beat. But then all of a sudden, a little bit after, it changes. You know, like, oh, man, it changed. That was on purpose, you know.
It's interesting that you said that because as I was listening and trying not to dance, because I'm stuck to my earphones here, but it was difficult. I felt like the integration of the back line, like your rhythm section is not just the rhythm section, right? It's a real sort of integrated into the whole. And I sort of appreciate that. And your description of trying to use the percussion to fill in some of those pieces is really helpful.
As a teenager, who did you listen to?
As a teenager?
Yes.
I listened really, I was a total snob about listening to John Coltrane and Sonny Stitt and Hank Mobley.
At 15.
Absolutely. Charlie Parker and Sonny Stitt and John Coltrane, to put it. That those were like, if you didn't listen to them, I didn't really want to talk to you that much.
Who introduced those artists to you?
In school, I learned about them. In school, I had a music teacher who was like, check out this album, Bird and Diz. Mm-hmm. And I was enamored, like, from the very beginning when I heard that song, Bloom Ditto. It's the first song on Bird and Diz. And I remember, like, Dizzy Gillespie has a mute in, and Charlie Parker, they play this melody in unison, and the sound they made together was, like, really just rich and, like, dark, and I really liked that sound, and I was just enamored from the beginning, and I played only flute at that point, so I wanted to, like, you know, I wanted to learn sax, because then I could kind of imitate that sound a little bit.
Describe your creative process.
It has to do with just really just getting an earworm, hearing, like, a just little, like, funny little melody that catches my attention, mm-hmm. and then I write it down, and then I forget about it for months. And then I can't sleep one night, and I look at that melody, and I something else that should follow that, like the next part of the melody follows, and then I just keep writing melody, and then I write like a beat that goes with it, and then I try to include those kind of things I was talking about, where if the melody hangs over the bar line, as it were, I try to accommodate for that, you know, in the rhythm section parts, and I write a bass line. I mean, this music is funny because there's no chords. There's no guy playing guitar and keyboard. So it's really just kind of only melody and bass line and rhythm. Like, all the melodies I play are pretty much like the other two horn players are playing with me, but playing different notes, you know, like making a chord. Mm-hmm. So that's kind of how the chords happen in this band. So in that way, like, everybody's job is really important in this band because we don't have, like, a keyboard player to pick up the slack for us, you know, as far as to make things richer or to put more rhythm, mm-hmm. to make more chicka-waka kind of things. Mm-hmm. So those things have to be written into the horn parts or into the bass and drum, conga, or percussion parts.
Mm-hmm. I see. Very good. Now, I noticed you took a dollar bill out of your wallet. I thought you were going to find a band for maybe they played off key or something. But
No.
Could you explain that?
Playing so good that I take money out and give it to him.
Is that how it works?
Normally I have gold shavings.
Okay.
I use gold shavings a lot to show my love for my band's music making.
Very good.
No, I'm just kidding. No, I use it to unstick my saxophone pads. The pad was sticking to the saxophone, so when I pushed that button, it wasn't doing what I was wanting it to do.
Okay.
So, yeah, I took it out, you know, ran it through there, kind of clean off some of that
right
stuff.
Right on. You know.
All right. We're speaking with Evan Francis, leader of the band Space Heater. We're happy to have them in studio with us tonight on Full Circle. I'm your host, Sukari, with Living Lamont. So I know you're part of the Jazz Mafia crew. Talk a little bit about the Jazz Mafia family.
Well, I think maybe now would be a good time to introduce my buddy Pat Corti, who's playing drums with us. He's a wonderful drummer. He knows a lot about the Jazz Mafia. What do you got?
Bring it on.
Well, Jazz Mafia is a collective of bands. Most notably, they're all pretty much working these days. The Shotgun Wedding Quintet, Brass Mafia, Realistic Orchestra, Space Heater, of course. A new band is called Brass Bows and Beats, and it's a symphony put together by Adam Thies. And that's like a 60-piece hip-hop symphony. Yeah, so we're all trying to do our thing.
Did you say a 60-piece?
Yeah, I said 60.
Wow. That's a lot of personalities.
Yeah, a lot of people. So we just did a show at Palace of Fine Arts in April, and then a run in a few weeks ago over in Yoshi's in San Francisco, and that was a lot of fun, a good turnout. Yeah, so it's a collective of bands, basically, and we're all kind of working together in each other's bands, and that can get kind of hard sometimes, but yeah, we're just trying to do our thing out there.
Okay, well, let's hear our next piece here, Intercom and Outer Materials.
Yeah, I might, since we're only going audio, we're not going visual on the radio, as we do, Intercom is spelled like intercom.
Intercom.
It's a play on words that doesn't come across if you only have the audio aspect.
You're tuned to Full Circle, 94.1 KPFA. Tuned to Full Circle on 94.1 KPFA. I'm your host, Living Lamont, with Sakari. You just heard from the group Space Heaters, Blast Furnace. And that piece that you heard was Intercom and Outer Materials. I understand you have a new release coming up next week.
That's correct. Let's see, we recorded this a few months back now, actually quite a few months back now. It's coming out on Ropadope Records. We're really stoked about that. It's a digital release. We make our own, you know, physical releases, hard copy. We're proud of it. It's actually a lot of our, we have made a lot of new tunes since we recorded this record, so we're already ready to make another one. But we're really into it. It's called Space Heaters Blast Furnace, which is, of course, the name of our band also.
Talk about the album and how your music has changed over the last few years.
Well, it's like I was saying before, I've definitely worked hard to incorporate a lot more clave and, you know, like there's a lot more timba, Cuban influence in there since our first record, which actually came out a few years back. I don't know. I think that I guess I've been listening to a lot of different stuff. I've been really influenced by the alto sax player and composer named Myron Walden. I've been influenced by an electronic musician who I actually have known since high school named Daedalus from L.A. And I've been listening to, actually, there's been a good amount of listening to this group called Kneebody. I've been listening to, like I said, Los Banban and Pablito F.A. and, you know, Charanga Habanera and those kind of bands from Cuba. So I don't know, I guess it's just changed. I've gotten a little bit weirder. I think I've steadily gotten weirder in my music, in my composing.
Very good.
To put it like how other people have put it to me.
So what upcoming events and things should we look out for from Space Heater?
September 29th, we're celebrating the release of our record, along with Crown City Rockers at the Independent in San Francisco.
Very good.
They're also putting something out that evening. The other gig that I would like to know, let you guys know about is the second Tuesday of every month. We play at a charming little place called Coda as part of the Jazz Mafia Tuesdays series. So every Tuesday there's something really cool happening at Coda in the Mission, in SF Mission, at DuBose and Mission right on the corner. Yeah, we also play the first Tuesday night of every month at Yoshi's SF in the lounge there as part of the Bay Vibes crew. So we have Tuesday things happening every month.
Where can people get the album and hear your music?
People can get our album once it comes out on September 8th. It'll be available on iTunes. If you just search for Space Heaters Blast Furnace, or probably just Space Heater, it'll probably come up if you just type that in. Also, it's coming out on the really cool label called Ropadope Records. So if you just do a search, Ropadope Records, you'll definitely be able to find us and other really cool music.
All right, great.
So let's jump off the band and let's hear some more music.
We're going to start off with a song called Outside Materials, which is a song I wrote. It's a programmatic play-by-play musical rendering of the day that Charlie Parker was born. And then we're going to continue for our last song. It's called Persistent. So here's Outside Materials.
And that was Space Heater with the tune Persistent. And before that, we heard Outside Materials. So be sure and check Space Heater out on the web at www.jazzmafia.com/spaceheater or at their MySpace site at www.myspace.com/spaceheater. And just a reminder, you don't want to miss their CD release party on September 29th at the Independent. So thanks, guys, for coming in. That was amazing.
Very nice.
Thank you. You are tuned to Full Circle on KPFA 94.1 FM. I'm Sukari, here with Living Lamont. Full Circle is a show put out by members of the First Voice Media Action Program, and we are currently doing outreach for a new apprenticeship group, Group 35. Coming up, we are going to play some commentaries from graduates of First Voice, Oscar Hernandez, Felicia Moore Jordan, and Jin Lei, produced by Kyung Jin Lee. If you want to apply to learn radio, blogging, live performances, and build community, apply now. Call 510-848-6767 extension 235 and request an application, or hit up our website at firstvoicemap.org.
I remember the many times I sat in traffic, going through all the radio stations. In one of those afternoons, I came across a program. It was about students walking out of their classrooms demanding better schools and not a new police station. That afternoon changed the way I heard radio. This time I was listening to the people in my community, bringing their stories about oppression and alternatives for solution. The stories about women who reflect my mother's struggle with machismo and poverty. It explored the reasons why my friend was serving time for robbery and why my neighbor had a drug problem. Since then, I wanted to take part of the community radio I was listening to, and I became part of Full Circle, a training program creating producers, reporters, and activists to uplift our communities. I now belong to a group, Voices of Revolution, bringing a radio of consciousness. Being part of this environment makes me feel like the first mosh pit I got into. It was at a Rage Against the Machine concert. I didn't know if I was going to come out with a broken arm or alive, but anger took over me and I found myself pushing through people twice as big. And this is what we are doing. We are standing up to the big guys. We are pushing and kicking fearless about the consequences. We are standing against the oppressor by producing Guerrilla Radio.
Be careful with your heart. This is for those of us who love too much, who work overtime to make sure everyone else's needs are met while ignoring our own, giving love so completely and continuing to feel burned when love isn't returned or appreciated. This is for those of us who try too hard, trying to save sisters, brothers, mothers, lovers, running around playing warrior princess for the world, trying to change those who don't want to be changed or really don't know how to love. When are we going to be there for ourselves? When are we going to put down our superhero capes and learn to love ourselves? Is it possible to accept a reality where we are the majesties of our own destiny, letting go of our preoccupation with taking care of others constantly? We must be careful with our own hearts, nurture our own souls so that we continue to love and grow. This year, maybe we can spend more time loving us, more time caring and sharing and inspiring ourselves. Learning to be the special person in our own lives. Be careful with your heart.
When you give all yourself away, just tell them to be careful of your heart. Careful of my heart.
Careful of his heart. Ask me what
I know about living in the aftermath of the Vietnam War, and I will tell you, it is visiting my brother in three different prisons throughout California. It is my father sitting drunk in front of a muted television set, tired of hearing English all day. It is my mother beating my father because she is tired of being beaten. It is standing in my kitchen and hearing over the radio that Chai Sua Vang, Hmong American man, has been arrested for the shooting deaths of six Caucasian hunters and the wounding of two others. The aftermath of war just ripples on and on for years. That first violent moment of bombs and guns, followed by the quieter violence of displacement, relocation, and assimilation. Then one day you are part of a gang, or you get arrested for beating your wife, or you find yourself in the woods, confronted by a group of white men, and you decide not to walk away. You let that hard kernel of sadness in your body erupt into rage. The United States exists in a perpetual aftermath of war. In between the fighting, the dead and the living alike are buried beneath terms like democracy, victory, stability, and peace. Trauma, despair, and depression are neatly woven away into the fabric of society. The violence of war always continues long after the war itself. Families and whole communities reside in its shadow. When we talk about gangs, domestic violence, drug abuse, alcoholism, unemployment, or homelessness, we are talking about war. We are talking about the long-term repercussions of state violence on people's lives. We are talking about a country and a government that is unwilling to be held accountable for the lives it has damaged. Let us be committed to following the trajectory of war, that bullet that spirals on year after year. Let us not be fooled by the government's rhetoric that peace is a given condition after war. Let us keep the trauma, the loss, the despair at the surface of our society, an open wound that we must acknowledge if we are to even consider the possibility of healing.
Again, thanks so much to our graduates for those great commentaries. We want to invite everyone to get more information about First Voice at firstvoicemap.org or call 510-848-6767, extension 235, and we will mail you an application. Special thanks to our production and technical interns from our mentors, Group 33, along with Group 34, the De La Mana crew that you guys met last week, Shayna, Courtney, Chago, Shauna, Sukari, Jane, Mwangi, Kinshasa, Lindsay, and Lamont.
Our executive producers are Renee G and Miss M, and our technical director is Free Willen Franklin.
Our intro music is by Source of Labor. Our outro music is produced by First Voice graduate B. Tondre. Special props to Josh Elmwood, Courtney, Miss M, Shauna Ray, and Frank for engineering tonight's show. Also, we want to let you know that Just Cause Oakland will be celebrating their 10th anniversary on Thursday, September 17th at the historic Suites Ballroom, 1933 Broadway in downtown Oakland. The celebration will take place from 6 p.m. to midnight. Rides and childcare are available. For tickets and more information, call Just Cause at 510-763-5877. Stay tuned for La Onda Bajita.